What are the best scientifically proven ways to boost your mental performance and brain power? Well, let's find out. Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Greg and I'm a brain hacker creating content that will help you upgrade your brain performance. If you're interested, then subscribe below and join our amazing community. Today we're gonna talk about boosting your brain and mental performance. Now, most people that I know try to achieve this peak performance, the state of being in the flow for a long period of time. And honestly, I am no different. Now, the best way to do it, to achieve this peak performance, is to optimize your cognition, to boost your brain power in a sustainable way that is going to work for a long time. Now, the worst thing you can do is to take some kind of a magical pill that's gonna quickly boost your alertness, boost your brain power, and then lead to a hard crash. Now, this is the worst thing you can do, and try to avoid doing that. So, what are some of the best scientifically proven brain hacks that can enhance your cognition and mental power? Well, let's check them out. Now, the first one that I wanna talk about is to get some sun exposure early in the morning. The best time to get it is as soon as you wake up. Now, why is this important? Now, once you go out, the sun will activate the so-called melanopsin ganglion cells, which are found in your retina, and those cells will trigger the correct timing of cortisol melatonin rhythms. Now, cortisol is a super crucial hormone, which we'll soon talk about more, but keep in mind, this is a hormone that will increase your energy levels in the morning, and that's what you want to get. You want to have lots of energy in the morning. And of course, melatonin is important for your sleep. So once you go out and you expose your body, especially your eyes, to the sun, these rhythms, the cortisol melatonin rhythms, will be set, and also your circadian clock, your inner 24-hour clock, will be set or reset, depends on how you look at it. So this is the most important thing you need to do in the morning to boost your focus, alertness, and mainly your energy levels. Now, the second thing you wanna do is to increase your epinephrine levels. Now, epinephrine is a neuromodulator or neurotransmitter that is important for alertness. That's one of the best ways to increase epinephrine level is by drinking coffee, if you like it. Coffee contains caffeine, which is a stimulant, which will increase epinephrine, which will increase alertness. Yerba mate is great. It's a really powerful tea. You can learn more about it up here. Green tea is great, but also just drinking a big glass of water will do the trick in a way, because hydration is so important, more than drinking coffee, obviously. And honestly, you don't really need coffee to increase alertness, but of course, coffee can help you out. Then the next way to increase alertness is to kind of boost your motivation. Now, if you do anything, what you're doing, if you do it out of love, out of fear, or out of anger, for example, well, this will lead to increased epinephrine levels. Now, without high epinephrine levels, you won't be alert, and without alertness, you won't be able to achieve peak performance. So the next trick I want to talk about is to increase cortisol levels. Now, people get cortisol all wrong, honestly. They see it as a stress hormone, and it is. High levels of cortisol for an extended period of time can cause a whole lot of problems. But high levels of cortisol for a short period of time are crucial to boost your energy levels, because that's what cortisol does. It increases your energy. Now, normally you get a peak of cortisol at about 9 a.m. That's totally normal, no matter what you do. And then cortisol levels will go down, and then you'll get another peak sometime around 2, 3, 4 a.m. in the morning. But if this cortisol spike in the morning is not strong enough, or if you're not really feeling energized in the morning, there are a couple of things that of course you can do. For example, you can take a cold shower. You can do the breathing exercise from Wim Hof, really effective way to boost cortisol levels. And of course, you can do a high intensity interval training early in the morning. This will definitely wake you up and increase your cortisol levels. By the way, guys, if you like this video, please press the like button below. Then you need to increase acetylcholine. Now, acetylcholine is a very important neurotransmitter for learning, memory, focus, and attention. And high levels of acetylcholine are associated with better learning. So how can you increase acetylcholine in your brain? Well, you can take some nootropics. For example, I'm a big fan of citicoline, an amazing nootropic. You can also take alpha GPC, and you can learn more about them up here in the video. Of course, you can eat foods that are high in citicoline, but they need to be low in saturated fats. Why? Because saturated fats decrease oxygen flow to the brain. So which are the best foods high in choline but low in saturated fats? Well, we're talking about soybeans, almonds, cruciferous vegetables, beans, quinoa, and so on. and they will help you increase acetylcholine levels in the brain. And then another trick is to look at a very small and narrow place, like for example the camera I'm looking at right now in front of me, for about 60 to 120 seconds. And this will also increase acetylcholine levels. Why exactly? Well, because mental focus follows visual focus. So if you're visually focused, mental focus will follow. You can try it out. I'm sure you're gonna like it and it's gonna work for you as well. Then you need to take the right nootropics for cognition. Now, I already mentioned taking acetylcholine, but of course there are many other nootropics that I recommend taking because they increase the amount of neurotransmitters in the brain, BDNF, they increase blood flow, and so on and so on. So some of the best nootropics for increasing brain power are Panax ginseng. It's a great adaptogen herb that can increase your energy levels, and the optimal daily dosage is about 200 to 400 milligrams per day. Then of course L-theanine, which promotes relaxation without drowsiness. L-theanine is an amazing nootropic for increasing focus and alertness, and you can take about 200 milligrams per day. Then phosphatidylserine, one of the best, my favorite nootropics on the market, because this is a special protein found in every cell of the body, in the membrane of the cells, and can significantly improve focus and attention. And the optimal dosage is about 100 to 300 milligrams per day. And last minute mushroom, great to protect your brain from degeneration, and you can take about 500 milligrams to about 1 gram per day. By the way guys, do you want to know how well does your brain perform? Go for a free brain assessment, link in the description below, and get your brain performance score. Then you need to optimize your diet. Now obviously there is no perfect diet out there. Some diets are good for some people, other diets are good for other people, but there are certain rules and there are certain types of foods that everyone should eat, because those foods and those ways of eating will improve your brain performance, and there is just no doubt about it anymore. Now we developed the so-called Brain Hackers Diet, which is not a real diet, but it is a way of eating to improve your brain performance. And here are a couple of rules I want to share with you. Well, first of all, try to eat more protein early in the morning and then more carbs later in the evening, because protein will increase dopamine levels and carbs will increase serotonin levels in the evening. And dopamine is associated with focus and attention, whereas serotonin is associated with better sleep. So this means you will be more focused in the morning and you will be more tired in the evening and you will have a better sleep. Of course, intermittent fasting is great. Many people ask me about it. It's great for increasing alertness. But if it happens to you that you suffer from a midday crash, now usually people crash about 2 to 4 or 5 p.m. If this happens to you, then you can still do intermittent fasting, but start it earlier. So eat an early dinner at about 5 or 6 p.m. and then do not eat anything till about 6 to 8 a.m. and then eat a really high quality breakfast. This is a better way to get the right nutrients in early in the morning. You'll still get the benefits from fasting and you won't crash in the afternoon. So try it out if you are crashing as well. It's also important to keep your blood sugar stable, and how you can do that, avoid all sugary drinks, all the sweet stuff out there, and try to eat fruits that are lower or have lower glycemic index. You also need to get some sun exposure in the evening. Now, why is this so important? First of all, if you get some sun exposure early in the morning, this means that your circadian clock will basically try to wake you up the next day a bit earlier. And then if you get some sun exposure late in the evening, your circadian clock will try to extend your day a bit longer, so you will be awake for a bit longer, and then on average you will go to bed every day at exactly the same time and wake up at approximately the same time. But there's another thing, the melanopsin ganglion cells that I mentioned before, actually those cells can be really sensitive in the evening to the all the light exposure there is. There's a lot of lights here right now, and if I would be filming this in the evening, that would cause some problems. Now if you get some real sunlight exposure in the evening, so when the sun is setting, your melanopsin ganglion cells will be less sensitive, which would have a really big positive impact on your sleep. Try it out, I'm sure you're gonna like the effect. Now there are other biohacks that you can do, and many people like to do, but people make so many really bad mistakes. For example, like drinking coffee early in the morning. You should never do that. Now, which are those biohacks, and how can you avoid those mistakes that you probably do as well? Well, check out the next video up here, and learn all about them. All right, guys, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me. Follow your Inception social media. And guys, I hope to see you soon again. Stay well.